People, something happened the other day. It was hilarious, and I need to tell you about it. So every year, I make a vision board. I cut images and words and phrases that inspire me, and I glue everything to a board. And then I put it up in my office so I can see it every day when I go into work. Oh, hey, I'm Susan Hyatt, and this is Go Time TV. This is the show about creating what you crave right now. Whatever it is, we're gonna create it right here on Go Time TV. I have to admit, I used to be pretty skeptical about vision boards, but once I actually learned about it and made one, I was like, oh, okay, this actually works. This is for real. So every single thing I put onto my first vision board, I achieved that same year. It's wild. So ever since then, I've been a believer because it's not just about gluing a bunch of random stuff to a board. It's about putting things on there that you feel emotionally attracted to. But you know, sometimes you put something in your office and then it's there for a while and eventually you kind of forget about it. It's there, but you don't really notice it much. It's fading into the background, like an old receipt that you totally forgot about, gathering dust. That definitely happened for me this year. I kind of stopped looking at my vision board and mostly forgot it was even there. I honestly didn't totally finish it either. It was, I would say, 85% done. And then one day, I was having a pretty tough day. I had to make some big decisions and I was feeling overwhelmed and exhausted and actually pretty sad. Not my best day. And I was rummaging around my office looking for something and it had snowed and I was opening the blinds so that my cat Moses could see out. And then I knocked my vision board down. It literally fell on my head. I was down on all fours. I stood up and picked up my board. What was funny is that my eye was immediately drawn to one phrase. It said, "Always remember that you are magic." And you know what? Seeing that phrase, it really hit me, especially on that particular day when I was not feeling very magical at all. And I felt like, well, this must be a sign. And I put this phrase onto my board for a reason, and then I forgot all about it. I forgot who I am. And then this board toppled onto my head to remind me. And I kept thinking about that moment and I realized, wow, I've gotten off track in the past month. I have allowed certain circumstances and people to dull me down and really dim my light. And I've been feeling scared and playing small. And I know it might not always look that way outwardly to my clients and viewers and all the folks in my community, but internally, that's how I felt. Dim, small. I temporarily forgot that I am magic. Sometimes it takes a bonk on the head to remind you who the hell you really are. So, my question for you is, what is a message that you really need to hear today? If a vision board was gonna bonk you on the head to deliver a message to you, an important message that your spirit needs to hear, what would it be? Maybe the message you need to hear is, it is never too late, or don't quit now that you've come so far and you're so close, or protect your time fiercely and stop giving it all away, or something else. If God or the universe was gonna send you a text message right now, what would it say? Whatever it is, say it to yourself. Say it daily and don't forget it. It's go time. And if this episode has brought you any joy, uplifted you, motivated you, inspired you, even in the tiniest way, please click like, please share, please subscribe to this channel because it's people like you who spread the word that make all the difference. Okay, so after it fell on my head, I realized and remembered who the hell I am. And then I also redid a lot of it. And so I'm gonna show you some additions that I made. And okay, so here I am serving up magic potion. I have heard that my alter ego this year needs to be Tina Snow. I'm all about it. The Queen of Swords. She has very strong boundaries and she's very direct. She gets what she wants. Some other things is, you may have heard me say before that Italy is my last retreat after being home for over a year due to COVID. We're going to all the places. Give me that vaccination because we're gonna go to Lake Como. We're gonna go to the French Alps. Y'all, it's gonna be lit. Here's some visual representation of some of the experiences that I wanna have. And so, yeah, I made some good changes and I'm feeling really good about it. Sometimes you need to get knocked around a little bit to get your truth rattled out. Okay.